Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, here in this video we will be announcing a brand new initiative in which what we will be doing, we will be covering daily one topic from your mains point of view. So the name of series is let's cover one topic first UPSC. So name is this, and in this what we will be doing, we will be picking up one topic that will be there in current affairs or that may be there in static part, and we will discuss it and will help you in enhancing your knowledge of this whole syllabus. So in this video, for today's lecture, we will be discussing Indian economy slowdown. So we will be discussing its causes and way forward. So you might have read the news or you might have heard them that Indian economy is facing a slowdown. So newspapers are reporting from various sectors that there is a slowdown, and here we will be discussing what are the causes and what should be the way forward. So how can we say that Indian economy is facing slowdown? Because obviously it is a debatable thing. Lot of people will say no, it is good, the health of economy is good, and others will say no, it is not good. So there, it is a little bit subjective topic due to its political nature as well. So what are the major signs? How can we justify our point? So justification can be done simply by pointing to major signs. So before proceeding, let me tell you friends that sometimes UPSC in your mains exam has the habit of asking justify. It gives you a directive that is justify. So in that case, whatever you write, you have to justify your point. So how can the justification how a particular thing can be justified? So that can be justified by pointing to a data so that you can substantiate your viewpoint. So similar is the case with the directive substantiate. Sometimes for example, if in mains exam there is a question that Indian economy is facing slowdown, justify this proposition. So you have to justify, then you can point to major signs, and also substantiate. The word substantiate also means the same. So what are, now let's proceed to our topic. So what are the major signs? So friends, unemployment is highest in 45 years. So you might have read the report of that is periodic labor force survey, in which it was said that the unemployment was highest at 6.1%. And then there is other sign that is that is coming from the automobile sector, that is there is a decline in sale of passenger vehicles to the tune of 30.98%. So it is almost 31%. And also experts are saying that this automobile sector is cutting the production units as well as workforce employed, because obviously when there is decline in sale of passenger vehicles, what they will do by producing more and more products, obviously if the previous inventory is not getting dried, and then why they will produce more? So obviously there will be cuts in production units as well as in the workforce employed. So also experts say that there is a close to 25 to 30% cut in production. So obviously you can see that 31% is the decline in the sale of passenger vehicles. So obviously the production will also be close to this number, this figure that is suggested by experts, and it is 25 to 30%. So also other thing is that there is 18.1 lakh crore non-performing assets of banks. So this clearly points to slowdown. So how it points to slowdown? Because obviously non-performing asset is not itself NPA. It becomes NPA when a particular borrower fails to repay his or her loan. So in that case, obviously when the persons or companies fail to repay, when their profits are declining, or they they experience negative profits. So in that case, obviously the loans of the banks become non-performing assets. So non-performing assets are approximately 18.1 lakh crore. So it doesn't include non-banking financial companies, which are also experiencing the liquidity crunch. And also then there is a report recently it was found that 13 lakh flats are lying unsold. So 13 lakh is a big number. So flats that are being constructed in urban areas, they are not getting sold. And also then they double the same number, that is 26 lakh are half finished. That is, the work is not going on in them. So basically, why the constructors will construct them? Because if their earlier flats are lying ideal, then what will be the purpose of making more flats? So that is the major sign. And also then there is, let's come to non-banking financial companies. So recently the infrastructure leasing and financial services are a major company that provide financial services in case of infrastructure projects. So it started defaulting on its liabilities. That is, it is now unable to repay its loans. So obviously a lot of non-banking financial companies had lent to this company. So obviously when it is defaulting, then the NBFCs are facing the liquidity crunch, because they are not getting loan back from this company or others as well. So obviously when they will be getting they will not be getting their loan back, so their money also turns into non-performing assets. So also then mutual funds, which invest in mostly these non-banking financial companies, they have approximately 70,000 crore exposure to non-banking financial companies. So obviously when they see that the health of NBFCs is not good, then why mutual funds will further invest? And then this increases further the liquidity crunch, because NBFCs are not getting their loan backs, and now their liquidity sources are also drying up because mutual funds are not investing in them. So these are the major signs. And then there is joblessness already, because of the joblessness, small businesses as well as individuals are also defaulting on loans. So also agriculture is becoming unprofitable. It would be wrong to say that agriculture is becoming unprofitable, because it never was profitable since independence. The condition of agriculture sector is not that good. So there is little return on investment. So all these things are the major signs. So what are the reasons for this slowdown? So you might say that, okay, these are the signs, and then what are the reasons? So some of the reasons can be before you. So obviously if unemployment is highest, then obviously there will be low demand, and when there is low demand, there is low economic activity, and when there is low economic activity, then this is called the slowdown phase. So many of the signs that are written here are in fact causes also. And then there is also joblessness, which is the reason, and also agriculture is not profitable. So this is the major employment provider in our country, agriculture sector. So when the people employed there are not getting profit, and then there will how they can demand the things that are made in industries, how they will demand the manufactured goods. So obviously there will be a kind of slump in economic activity. So major reasons, now let's focus solely on the major reasons. First of all, the demonetization was the biggest body blow to the economy, because it created the liquidity crunch. Regarding its impact, that what was the positive impact of demonetization, it is debatable, but one thing is for sure, that it created liquidity crunch, which affected the informal sector the worst, because the informal workers, or for example women who were employed by the employers, they were sent back home because the employers didn't have the cash to pay them. So when they didn't have the cash to pay them, then why will the workers will work? So obviously they came back home, so they lost their jobs, and when they lost their jobs, they lost the money in their hands, and thus consequent demand slowed down, and then there is also a decline in economic activity. And then there is also issue of NBFCs, because we know that non-banking financial companies lend to micro, small and medium enterprises. So when NBFCs faced the liquidity crunch due to the IL and FS crisis, and also due to the due to lack of investments by mutual funds, then their ability to lend MSME sector decreased. And you must know that, friends, that MSME sector plays a major role in Indian economy because it provides up employment to 12 crore people, and also it contributes to 45% of the exports of India. So basically, when this sector, which employs so much number of people, it is not getting credit, then obviously their expansion plans or their modernization plan or their operational plans will be kind of affected. So due to this, obviously the 12 crore people which are employed in this sector will also be consequently affected. And then there is also issue of GST, that is goods and services tax. Though this is a reformist tax, it is alleged that it was introduced in haste and with little preparation, and also it increased the compliance cost, especially of the this MSME sector, which is already cash starved. So also recent controller and auditor general report highlighted that how cumbersome its nature is, that is how user unfriendly it is. So that is increasing compliance cost and diverting the attention of these MSMEs or businesses to more to paperwork than to they fail to focus on their business more. So this is also one of the reasons. And then there is lack of demand. So obviously lack of demand is due to multiple reasons. So as I have told you already, agriculture sector is stressed, and then there is joblessness, and people don't have the cash in their hands. Obviously there is retrenchment going on in various sectors, as I have earlier told in this automobile sector. So production has been cut to the tune of 25 to 30%. So obviously when this retrenchment or laying off is taking place, so there will be lack of demand also in that case, because people are losing the money that was earlier in their hands. And then there is other reason, that is high NPAs of banks. So high NPAs, as I've told you, 18.1 lakh crore NPA is not a small amount. So obviously banks they are kind of we can say they are discouraged to lend, because their NPA is quite high, NPA figure is quite high, and they are not feeling that confidence to lend more. So obviously when there is not no lending, then obviously the investment will not come. So when investment will not come, then the economy will obviously face a slowdown. And then there is also lack of animal spirits among entrepreneurs. So this animal spirit is also a kind of, we can say, so these are various things that feed into one another. So why there is lack of animal spirits? Because there is non-lending by banks, because there is a lack of demand. And all these things, as I've told you, they feed into each other. So each reason becomes a reason for other, and this creates a kind of cycle that could be termed as vicious cycle. So more other things are that there are structural issues than there are in Indian economy. For example, land like acquisition laws are complex. So then there are other infrastructural costs, for example logistic costs, which render the Indian products uncompetitive in global market. So Indian INC is not that competitive in global market. So these are the major reasons. So what should be the way forward now? So as I've told you, reasons have been told. Now the way forward is obviously to recapitalize banks and NBFCs so that they can lower the interest rates and so that they are able to lend. And there is also there must also be focus on addressing the loopholes in GST. And then revamping agriculture sector is very important by giving boost to food processing industry. So that will come only through when there is a kind of that Essential Commodities Act of 1955 that is reformed. And then there are APMC's acts which are creating stress in agriculture sector. So all these things must be addressed. And then there must also be focus of the government on increasing spending in infrastructure and affordable housing. So what can this lead to? This can lead to immediate job creation and can lead to consequent demand generation, because when there is job creation, certainly the people will have money in their hands and they will demand, and that can revive animal spirits, or at least can push the entrepreneurs to invest more. So this can have this can be done, and then there must also be structural reforms that must be brought in, that like easing of land acquisition laws and addressing infrastructure flaws which raise cost, for example logistics. And then there must also be sector specific interventions. Say for example, if automobile sector is experiencing demand slump, then there must be sector specific interventions. If say for example, real estate is facing the issue, then there must also be a consequent rectifying kind of, we can say, act, so that the sector sector-wise growth can also be revived and sectoral activity can also be revived, so that the overall economy can be revived. So this is the this was the major topic today which was there, which we discussed with you. So thank you. If you are friends interested to read more such articles and want to download the PDF of this article as well, you can visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in. The link of which it is provided in the description box, and you can also join us on our Telegram channel, that is the link of which is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. So we frequently update our various activities that we do on our YouTube channel, on our Telegram channel also. So you are invited to join that Telegram channel so that you can remain updated about our various initiatives. So this is all about today's video. If you liked it, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.